Far removed from civilization at the end of this lonely Louisiana highway sits Angola Prison, once known as the bloodiest in America, home to murderers, rapists, and other criminals. Its infamous legacy has been captured in movies like Monsters Ball and Dead Man Walking.
Purcell had it coming to him. You understand? He had it coming.
But today, inmates and prison officials have come to think of this place much differently. At first glance, this might look like a typical worship service. However, take a few steps outside the church and you begin to see it's anything but.
They want the world to know that they are changed. They have changed their lives. They have changed their ways. This is the land of new beginnings. They want the world to know that we can change too.
Like a tree that's planted by the water, hey, I shall not be on my way.
Warden Burl Kane says more men will end up dying here than ever being released. Still, some have a newfound hope due to the transformation that's taken place here. Change came as a result of heavy emphasis on what Kane calls moral rehabilitation and faith-based programs. There's even a Bible college within the walls that has produced about 150 preachers. Kane says they're so good that he chooses to worship with the inmates he's charged to oversee.
Think about Paul. Look, man, he killed all those, he persecuted Christians and killed them. He's the greatest Catholic. I told that to the Catholics here. You know, why don't you let an inmate be a priest? They should. Because they shouldn't say, because you're in prison. God changes people, and we're supposed to, you know, the only thing permanent is change. And we go to Philippians 3:13, which says, I don't look to the past, I press on to the future. Well, why can't inmates do it too?
One who is pressing on is Harold Brand, sentenced to life at age 19 for second-degree murder.
What changed us? The love of God. You know what I mean? And the Bible says in Proverbs, it says, love covers a multitude of sins. And see, that's why we're able to change, because of God's love. You come here and you look around at Angola, it reminds me of that poor choice I made, or that great mistake in my life that I made. But see, God doesn't, he don't do that. He reminds you of your future. We have a future with God.
Joining with the child-focused ministry Awana, the prison is looking toward the future, offering rehabilitated fathers a chance to have a positive impact on the next generation.
So help me God.
So help me God.
This crowd of men, more than 300 strong, all represent fathers, grandfathers, uncles, and they're all here for one purpose. You see, they understand the hard reality of doing time means kids of incarcerated parents are 7 times more likely to wind up behind bars. So they're here with one message, to make sure that doesn't happen to their kids.
One special event is called the Returning Heart Celebration. Each year, hundreds of kids spend a day at the prison with their dads, eating, playing games, and riding rides.
I don't get to experience the birthdays or the holidays, you know, so now I get to experience this with her.
But the purpose goes much deeper than having fun. It's designed to let these kids know their fathers love them and that they don't have to become a statistic by falling into some generational curse of crime.
To allow him to know and other people to know that it does not exist. Statistics are something that people gather as numbers, like a census. When you love your children and you love your family, things can be changed.
For the kids, it's an emotionally charged day, too.
The only thing that keeps me going is seeing my dad.
Is he your hero?
Yes.
And that impact carries over to the volunteer chaperones.
Just to know that their dads want them and write them letters and care about them and pray for them and want Jesus in their life is absolutely amazing, because for me personally, that's never happened in my life. So for just to see, you know, I would love to know that my dad was locked up even somewhere and cared about me. He's out in the world and doesn't. So just for these kids to have the opportunity to know that their dads love them is absolutely amazing.
The children's safety and security are a top priority, and organizers say after 5 years, not one bad incident has been reported. They believe that's because the program focuses on changing the heart.
We spend $49 billion in this country for correction. We send more people into prison than any country in the world, but our recidivism rate is 73%. Why? Because we focus on education, we can focus on vocational. They're good, but without a changed heart, you're only making smarter criminals.
Some experts say events like these can often help both parent and child.
What we've learned from our research is that contact between the prisoner and family members, increased contact both with family members and ties to their minor children, is predictive of greater success on the outside.
The victims were not the only victims of these inmates. but their children are also a victim because they lost their father in the process.
Go get them.
Now it's about finding those fathers and the love that was lost. Warden Kane takes comfort in knowing that if the message gets through to even one child, that's potentially one fewer person behind bars.
You see these dads, you see the kids, you see the games. What goes through your mind?
These kids not coming to prison, and these kids not breaking the law, and these kids not leaving behind victims, and these dads are rewarded. You can't measure the impact and what's going to happen from this and what could happen. So it's really a great thing.
It's worth it.
Can you put a value on one victim? And it's like I said, if we say one victim of violent crime, it's worth my whole career, worth everything I do.
John Jessup, CBN News, reporting from the Louisiana State Penitentiary at Angola Farm.